Our next guest suffered a horrendous injury in an unprovoked attack at a party. He survived and continues to make an incredible recovery. We'll meet Liam Knight shortly, but first, here's his story. Nearly 2 years ago, Liam was at a mate's 18th birthday party, but within just a few short hours, he was fighting for his life.
The teenage boy is on life support after a birthday party brawl on Sydney's northern beaches. The 17-year-old was impaled through the head with a steel pole during a fight with gatecrashers.
A group of gatecrashers had jumped a fence, one teenager throwing a 2-metre metal rod that pierced Liam's skull. He was placed in an induced coma and rushed to hospital. During emergency surgery, doctors successfully removed the rod. But Liam remained in a coma for another 12 days before finally opening his eyes and beginning his long but incredible journey of recovery. Please welcome to Studio 10, Liam Knight.
Good to be here.
Liam, thank you for joining us. You look so incredibly well. Can you remember, just going back to that night, can you remember much about that night or waking up from the coma?
Kind of waking up the coma. The night, remember some details. I remember I was having a good night and then kind of just went downhill from there. And then next thing I wake up in a coma, just super confused where I was.
Did you realise what had happened when you woke up?
No, I was still kind of tripping out from the all the drugs they were giving me. Mm. And then probably maybe a week later, that's when I started asking questions why I was in that position I am in. And so that's where I found out what actually happened, and I kind of started freaking out then.
We saw you leaving the hospital and you were using a walking stick. Now, we've seen you come join us today and you're not using a walking stick, but how difficult has it been for you to get to where you are now?
It's been a long recovery. It's been really, really hard on me, but I kind of just stuck through it and, you know, kept pushing through.
What was the hardest thing?
I guess learning to walk again. I was in a wheelchair for probably, I don't know, it happened in January, probably 2-3 months after. That's when I started actually getting on the walking stick. Just pushing myself through it, and then, you know, sitting in a wheelchair day after day, just, you know, you get over it, but, you know, you got to get through it, and, yeah, it's just something.
And you've had your family around you.
Yes.
And your brother and your girlfriend, Astrid.
Oh, God. I thought we'll talk about that in private.
There's nothing private here.
They've been really good to me. My mates have been there every day when I was in hospital. My family, you know, they treat me normal. All my mates still rip into me every day. Well, that's what you kind of need. You need your good mates
absolutely.
To keep you grounded.
Liam, I don't think a lot of people realise after a brain injury how extraordinarily difficult the whole rehabilitation process is. As you said, you needed to learn to walk again. How tough has that been? Because you must have incredible courage.
Yeah, it's been really tough, but with the support I actually had around me, that's what really got me through it. When you're in a wheelchair every day and in rehab, you got nothing else to do, so I was just going to the gym maybe 4 hours a day, just pushing myself, and I'd set myself goals every day, such as walking 10 metres unassisted or something small. Wow. give myself a time limit. And then kind of it all just built up, and then I started working with Fresh Tracks a bit, and then that started building up my strength a lot, and then it's kind of just come back from there, and it's really good.
How are you helping other people with brain injury now that you're going so well with your own?
So with Fresh Tracks, I'm a mentor at the hub at St Ives. So they're doing a lot of trike riding and helping out a lot there. And really it's just, it's really helping with my strength. It's really helping with just, you know, looking around, getting your actual brain to work and kind of getting back to normality, as in, like, when you're riding, you got to look out for other people, you got to look out for all the, you know, all the things on the road.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really good, and it's really good for the social aspect as well. it's really helping out with, you know, all the mm-hmm. all the younger kids as well, so it's really good.
That looks quite fun, actually.
Yeah, it is.
That's going to have a go either.
Yeah, well, fantastic young man. And thank you for joining us this morning, and good luck. You are just fantastic. Wow. What a wonderful young man.